Well, that was fucking brilliant.
Say it ain't so.
Say it ain't so.
Help
it ain't so.
Thank you, sir.
What do we got? 5,000-6,000 people here today?
Minimum.
Minimum. Well, I'm disappointed because I invited all my friends. None of them showed up.
There!
He's drunk. Do not listen to him.
I'm not.
But who cares? Because it don't matter. That's what it's all about, right? I was going to... Big Al is smaller than I am.
So I'm ready to take over that thing.
I was going to get up here and rattle on about being sued in federal court by a bunch of pinheads over at this public access station, but I ain't going to bore you all to tears. You know what I'm saying? Bore you to tears? Anybody? Nobody gives a fuck. Nobody cares. Nobody cares if what it's just, you know what it is? It's simply a tip of the iceberg. It's a tip of the iceberg. They sue me in federal court for putting tits and ass on television. And the next thing you know, they're gonna start kicking in your front door because you're dressed up like a clown, like this character over here. Say, oh no, that's not correct. You can't put on a suit with pink on one side and red on the other. You've got it backwards. It's supposed to be red on one side, pink on the other.
Stand next to him.
Like I said, I ain't gonna bore everybody to tears because I don't want to talk about it. But here's the clown I was talking about.
He's an idiot. I'm an idiot.
I thought he meant me. Anyway.
I got no rights.
That's right. Clowns have no rights in this country. Did you know that?
You're dressed funny.
We're worse off than the Mexicans.
You're dressed funny, and you're dressed funny. I'm dressed normal.
But I'm
good evening, and welcome to DWTV, Dickwad Television for the ignorant masses that watch our station. My name is Sherry Baby, and our program this evening is Show Up. That's because we're always grateful if our guests do indeed show up. God, why aren't I at NBC? Our guest this evening is Angsto the Clown, fresh from a rally on October 6th, protesting his obscenity charges coming up in federal court. The rally promptly turned into a police riot. Angsto has agreed to appear with us this evening, although his counsel, Dewey, Fuckum, and Howe, are in the studio with us. Clown, humorist, comic, an outlet for the pathos of the people? Or perhaps a purveyor of the obscene, adulterer, fornicator, and unholy demon? And welcome back to our program, Show Up. I'm Sherry Baby, and our guest this evening is Angsto the Clown. Once again, we'd like to emphasize that Mr. Angsto Clown is represented in our studio by Dewey, Fuckum, and Howe.
And they're good. They're good. They're the fucking best.
Well, I'm sure they are.
Hey, you think Angsto, you'd have some of your crew put the goddamn mic on me? Jesus Christ.
No, sir. We're a cheap station. Angsto, welcome to our program.
How you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
I know. You're damn nice.
That's what they all say. The first and most important question, is your program comedy or obscenity?
Is that a rhetorical question, or... Am I actually supposed to answer that?
One would assume you have a few thoughts since you are being taken to federal court, sir.
No, it's not obscene at all. There's nothing at all to do with obscenity. It's comedy.
Mm-hmm.
Adult humor.
Mm-hmm. Could you define adult humor, please?
No.
No. All right, sir. As I recall, there are bare breasts.
You smell
breasts.
Good, you know.
Thank you. Bare breasts, bare bottoms, some sadomasochistic activity.
Yeah, lots of tits and ass, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Whippings, beatings,
mm-hmm. Just the basics, sir.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And how would you define obscene?
The same as the federals do. The feds define it as, big wet dicks and big wet pussies and, you know, doing
uh-huh.
it.
Uh-huh.
Can't see your face. Come on, come on, come on. Give it to me, baby.
All right, sir, we understand you are fresh from an rally protesting those obscenity charges.
An obscenity rally, yes.
Uh-huh, with a crowd, we understand, of 5,000 to 6,000 people.
Immensely successful.
We understand that it disintegrated rapidly into a police riot situation on the State House grounds.
I was about halfway through my speech, and some cop came up and whacked my cameraman in the side of the head, and that was the end of it.
And why did he do this, sir?
Because my cameraman is a fucking ugly son of a bitch. I can't blame him.
That would explain it.
You're the TV girl. Come on. You're the tasty TV twat. Oh, I'm sorry. I take that back.
Angsto.
Yeah.
I think that you are personally rather attractive.
I thought you were going to say offensive.
Threw you off guard.
That's right. You're going to lose your job. You're not very good, goddammit. Give
lost.
Us a kiss. Come here, give us a kiss, baby.
I'm also
give
very
us a kiss,
hot.
God damn it. You're doing all right. Keep it rolling, sweetheart. Come on.
The rally. Who else participated in the rally that day with you, sir?
There you go. Who participated? I'll tell you what. It was immensely successful, as I said. I had Big Al's Rhythm and Blues Review.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent blues band, the best in the nation. Oh, yeah, and Damon Zex and his lovely girlfriend, the Arachnid Goddess, was there.
The Arachnid Goddess.
Oh, yeah, yeah, she's a tasty
she's
morsel.
She's the one with the bare buttocks.
Big bear buttocks. Big bear buttocks.
Big bear, do you give them a big bear hug?
We're not doing any promos for anybody out here, sister. Fuck Buck Big Bear.
Don't listen to him, he's drunk.
Come on, sweetheart. Questions.
Questions.
Yes. Am I making you horny?
Yeah.
I have that effect on women.
Oh, see, I can't tell if you're talking to Sherry or to me.
No, I'm talking to you, sweetheart.
Go turn that thing off.
Come on, Sherry, baby.
That hasn't been mentioned here is, you know, I find Howard offensive from time to time myself.
Me what?
So if you don't want to listen to it, turn it off. That's
I think that that's the
whole
best
issue.
Exercise.
Yada, yada, yada. What else? I was going to cover some other shit, but I seem to have forgotten. But it don't fucking matter.